The truth is, record labels are the gatekeepers to mainstream music. They have long dictated who gets in the industry and who becomes a household name. When an artist is supported by record labels, there's no limit to their success. But when an artist gets on a record label's bad side, things can be devastating for the artist, with the artist losing all control of their career. Join me in this episode as we uncover the dark truth about record labels. Many, if not all, artists on the come up dream of one day being discovered by a record label. They fantasize how it would feel to sign that dotted line and to finally know that they have the right people pushing their music on their side. Most artists are willing to sign their souls away for this opportunity. They have worked their entire lives trying to make it to this point. So imagine how it would feel when you finally get the opportunity you've been dreaming of and working so hard towards, and you realize it doesn't feel so much as a dream, but more like a nightmare. Record labels do not care about the artist. They care about the money the artist can make them. That's the reason we see so many artists denounce the record labels that they have entrusted their careers in. These artists realize too late that the record labels were finessing them, using them as long as they can make the label money, then tossing them to the side. Like I said in my last record label video, the record labels use the record deal to enslave an artist. Once an artist signs that dotted line, they now become property of that label. They trap artists with big advances and bad deals before the artist even has a chance. This is a lesson learned by upcoming artists on the regular basis. They work on their music for years and finally manage to make a great song that people like that's managing to pick up traction. The record labels get to this artist before they start to see any real money and offer them an amount of money that they have not seen in their lifetimes to sign a deal with them, quickly blinding the artist by telling them how they can take their careers to the next level and how much money they can make together. The artist, feeling like this is their only shot, quickly signs that deal without giving it much thought, without at all knowing that they just got finessed. The only reason the record labels even approach the artist is because they know money is about to come in for that artist. They want a cut of their action, and they know if they get to the artist before he has made any real money, it's much easier to blind them with a few $100,000 advance. Now the record label gets a percentage of the profits of your hit song forever, while you get a terrible loan that you have to repay at a set interest rate. For example, in the recent Diddy video I made, I briefly spoke about Mace and his contract issues. Diddy is one of the music execs that is known for finessing his artists out of their money, and we clearly saw that with what he did to Mace. Not only did he sign Mace to a bad record deal worth about $250,000, but Diddy managed to convince Mace to give him his masters for only $20,000. In the mid-2000s, while 50 Cent was at his prime, he was in the works of signing Mace to G-Unit, but Diddy allegedly wanted $2 million for Mace's contract, the same $2 million that Mace would eventually offer Diddy for his masters, which Diddy rejected. Diddy has had many issues with artists he signed. For example, The Lox, mainly Jadakiss, came out publicly to denounce Diddy and accuse him of doing the same he did to Mace to him. Diddy took large amounts of Jadakiss publishing rights. Jadakiss was asked to be let out of his deal with Bad Boy, which he eventually accomplished. Diddy isn't the only music exec out here robbing upcoming artists blind either. This is a practice that has been going on since the beginning, but in 2021, it has become easier for record labels to sign profitable artists and steal their money. All the labels have to do is look for the artists who are already gaining recognition and sign them before they blow up. Once artists realize they made the label millions of dollars, but haven't made themselves nothing near that, they start to question their deals. They want out of their record deal, or they want to renegotiate. This is when the record labels start to show their claws. They would try to calm the artist down by explaining that this is how the business works. When the artist doesn't buy that story, the record label won't allow the artist to drop their music and stops marketing the artist, essentially bringing the artist's career to a stop. What QC did to the Migos shows how corrupted the industry is. While the Migos were signed to QC, they were introduced to Damian Granderson, who became their lawyer, who would negotiate deals on behalf of the Migos between them and QC. The problem was that Damian was also QC's lawyer, which not only brings up conflict of interest, but it was also discovered that Damian was purposely having the Migos sign bad deals that would put more money in the pockets of the labels and himself. When the Migos discovered what was going on, they had already lost millions, which they had to spend more money to resolve in court. The record labels love to work in secrecy to get what they want from the artist. They have done a great job of manipulating artists to believing that without them it's impossible to make it big. But in all reality, it's the other way around. The record labels need the artists to make money. If they don't sign artists, they can't make money off them. So they created their value by providing the money and the connections needed to be mainstream. Before technology improved and the internet merged with the music industry, artists truly needed record labels to make it. It was almost the only way to be seen by the world. The record labels knew they needed to keep control of the artists that managed to build an audience, because those are the ones that make the most money and have the most influence. Greed is always what fuels these execs into becoming thieves who are willing to say and do anything to convince artists to sign that dotted line. Like I briefly covered in my Lil Wayne video, Wayne actually got into a disagreement with his boss Birdman. The man Wayne once called his daddy, he was now calling him all types of names and accusing him of robbing him blind. Wayne accused Birdman of taking most of his royalties illegally and using it to fund his lavish lifestyle. When Lil Wayne brought this up to Birdman, Birdman decided it was time Lil Wayne's career ended. Birdman even tried to replace Lil Wayne with Young Thug. He was even going to allow Young Thug to name his album The Carter 5. When Lil Wayne didn't back down to Birdman, instead decided to take him to court, Birdman allegedly would end up convincing Young Thug's tour manager to spray up Lil Wayne's tour bus. By the grace of God, no one was hurt, but Wayne knew what was happening. Birdman was trying to get rid of his problem. Lil Wayne eventually sued Birdman in two different lawsuits, one for $50 million and again for $40 million for money Birdman stole from Wayne that Nicki and Drake made. Lil Wayne claimed that Birdman and UMG were both conspiring to keep Wayne from getting his money owed from Nicki Minaj and Drake. Birdman tried to do everything in his power to erase Lil Wayne, literally. He tried replacing him with Young Thug, and if Wayne didn't stand up for himself, who knows what would have happened. If you would like to see a full video on Young Thug, comment Young Thug below. If 350 people comment Young Thug, the next video will be about him. This isn't the first time record labels have been accused of trying to take out artists they have a disagreement with. Many people on the internet strongly believe that what happened to Michael was due to issues with Sony Records. Like I explained in the video I did on Michael, he managed to acquire ATV Records, which had parts of the Beatles catalog. Michael sold a percentage of his ownership of ATV to Sony when he was tight on money. Sony wanted the entire catalog from Michael, which was worth hundreds of millions, which Michael refused to sell. This began the problem between the two, and the record label started to do what they do best, mess with the artist's career. When Michael was set to release his Invincible album, the label didn't do their part to promote and market the album in the US to show Michael a lesson. When Michael decided to take Sony to court for sabotaging his album is when Michael truly sealed his fate. Michael was even tricked into hiring a lawyer who was secretly working with Tommy Mottola, who was the president of Sony Records at the time, to represent him in court. After Michael hired a private investigator, he was able to find out that the lawyer even had a joint account with Tommy Mottola overseas. Michael stood up to Tommy, even calling him the devil. Michael was even seen holding gatherings in support of his freedom from his contracts with Sony, where he would expose Sony's evil actions. Just 1 month after Michael's passing, he would be officially free from his deal with Sony. This wouldn't last long because his family would then sell all Michael's rights to Sony, including his portion of ATV Records. If you ask me what I think, it clearly looks like they got rid of the problem, just like we saw Birdman try to do with Wayne. Record label execs are shady, and this is how they manage to live like gods off the backs of their artists. They would do anything in their power to keep control of their cash cows. Some artists get so trapped by the label that it becomes almost impossible for an artist to have their freedom back. The label will use any method of manipulation to assure that the artist can't escape. Sometimes it's not only the record labels who are solely responsible for robbing an artist, it could even be members of their own family who get involved when they get greedy, like we saw with Britney. Britney accused her father and record label, which is to no surprise Jive Records and Sony Music, of putting her in a conservatorship so that they may be able to control her life and her money. She accused the label and her management of forcing her to perform when she physically didn't feel fit for it. They prevented her from having children and kept her on medications that kept her out of it. The record labels have earned themselves a reputation of being disloyal to the very artists that make them rich and successful. The bigger the artist becomes, the more the record labels take advantage of them. The labels were never in it for the music or the artist. It has simply been about influence and money. Even Snoop Dogg, all the way in the 90s, accused Suge Knight of robbing him of money that was rightfully his, using the same methods that record label execs have been using for years. What's even worse is when an artist not only accuses an executive of robbing them, but also accuses them of much more sinister things. Kesha sued the owner of her record label she was signed to, stating that he manipulated her and took advantage of her, and she wasn't just talking about in music. She would later drop the charges, and to me this means they most likely settled out of court. The record labels have been able to do this to artists with no real consequence. Their money can be used to silence anyone they choose. They trick these young artists who know nothing about the industry to take bad deals that are really just very bad loans. They gain access to the rights of their hit songs and keep them forever, and the artist starts to go broke and lose everything, while the music exec stacks up hundreds of millions a year. The record labels have managed to rob artists legally, and the artist can't really do nothing about it once they sign. The few artists that have tried to stand up for themselves usually meet devastating ends. I'm not at all saying that all record labels are bad. Simply what I'm saying is most have been proven to be crooks who do what they must to steal from hardworking artists. My advice to upcoming artists is simply build your company up yourself. As I explained in my independent artist video, it may be harder to make it independently, and it will most likely take longer as well. But you know that you get to keep your soul and your money, and no one will be trying to finesse you out of what you're making. Even though the music industry looks exciting and is full of endless riches from the outside, when artists finally get a glance inside, they find out what the industry really looks like. It's not at all how it's painted to be. We must remember we cannot allow record labels to manipulate us. As great as they might look making artists superstars, they might not be doing it for the right reasons. We must remember what agenda these execs truly have, and we must remember what they're willing to do to enforce it. Thank you for watching this episode of The Truth Is. I just wanted to let you know that I have started a second channel, and whoever subscribes before September 25th will be automatically entered to a giveaway, where I would be picking 3 winners, each getting $50, and a Know The Truth shirt. If you would like to further support the channel, join me on Patreon, the link would be in the description. If you join me before the 28th of this month, you could be entered to this month's monthly raffle, where you can win a shirt, a cash prize, and even pick a video topic. Also, please leave a comment below on your thoughts on this video and on any future topics you would like to see me cover on my channel. If you like this video, please hit the like button as this helps other people find these videos. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe and hit the bell so you can be notified of future videos. Please follow me on Instagram at TheTruthIs01 and on TikTok at TheTruthIs. I would gladly appreciate it. Thank you. Goodbye.